Welcome to Vibe Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you the types of cryptocurrencies that you must know about in order to wisely invest in crypto. But before we start to discuss cryptocurrency types, let's first understand the difference between coins and tokens in crypto. So, coins are assets on their native blockchain, whereas tokens are assets foreign to the blockchain they live on. Examples of coins are Bitcoin on Bitcoin blockchain and Ether on Ethereum blockchain. And examples for tokens include Uniswap or UniToken and Chainlink or Link token that are used on Ethereum blockchain. Please note that in some conversations, articles, and videos, the two terms are used interchangeably, and while the distinction between coins and tokens is technical, we can group tokens and coins by their intended usage. Further, there are a lot of crypto types. Let's start by discussing each one by one. Number one, security token. Here, by security, we mean it as a tradable financial asset. The Howey test is used to help us tell if an asset is a security or not. As per US Security Act, a security can be defined as a contract, transaction, or scheme whereby a person invests his or her money in a common enterprise and is led to expect profits solely by the efforts of the promoter or third party. Confused? Let's simplify them with a set of questions to consider while you're investing in securities. Like, number one, was there an investment of money? Number two, was the money invested in a common enterprise? Number three, was there an expectation of profit? And number four, are the profits solely from the efforts of the promoter or a third party or not? The examples for such security tokens can be found by looking for security tokens offerings or STOs on ICO Holder and CoinCodex.com. And just to answer a popular debate, Bitcoin is not a security token because the money is not invested in a common enterprise. Further, security tokens can be divided into two types. First one is equity token. These are the types of security tokens that allow the holder to have some ownership rights over something. Some examples of equity tokens include the Elephant Private Equity Coin and Recovery Right Token or RRT. Further, second one is asset-backed tokens. Here, the tokenization of assets makes them more tradable. That is, instead of trading the asset itself, you trade the token, and it is very similar to paper money we use today. Wherein, instead of trading gold, you trade paper which represents a certain amount of gold. But the issue with asset-backed tokens is the lack of oversight. And of course, the issuer of the token can claim to back that the asset is backed by anything, but without actual checks, this claim isn't worth anything significant. Also, for your knowledge, here are some of the assets that can be tokenized. First, precious metals. For example, Pax Gold and Bigix Gold token are backed by gold. Second, company shares. Here, instead of trading company shares via well-known exchanges, they could be traded as crypto tokens. Next, liquid commodities. For example, the petrodollar is claimed to be backed by oil and mineral reserves. And further, real estate. There are multiple tokens around real estate, and several countries look into representing real estate as a crypto token. The IHT token seems to go into this direction, but it also makes an impression that it's not ready yet. Next one on the list, number two, utility token. As security tokens are traded with the expectation to get direct profit from them, in contrast to these, utility tokens are traded with the expectation to serve some essential purpose or to get some utility out of them. For example, a Filecoin token or a Siacoin token can be used to store file. And the CVC or Civic token can be used to verify a user's identity. In the real world, gift cards and public transportation tickets are examples of utility tokens, and other examples of utility tokens are Basic Attention Token and the Golem token. Number 3. Non-fungible tokens or NFTs. All coins and most tokens are interchangeable. If you have multiple $1 notes, it doesn't matter which one you use to pay for a snack. However, if you buy a collectible such as art, comics, stamps, or baseball cards, it does matter which one you have. We all know that no Van Gogh is same as any other Van Gogh. The digital equivalent of this is CryptoKitties. The idea is that you and only you can have some digital value. This property is especially attractive for computer games where players already pay a lot for rare items within the game. By putting those on blockchain gives the player more control over their earned assets, and just maybe it would even be possible to trade the items across games in the upcoming future. What if, right? Number 4. Stablecoins. Now, stablecoins are digital representations of fiat currencies. They fall into one of these three groups. First one, fiat collateralized. This cryptocurrency is backed by fiat currency. Examples are Tether and Gemini dollar. Next, crypto collateralized. This cryptocurrency is backed by another cryptocurrency. An example is DAI. Next, non-collateralized stablecoins, which rely on smart contracts to buy, sell the stablecoin in order to keep their price constant. Interestingly, several stablecoins are not actually coins but tokens. Two examples of actual stablecoins are Terra USD and Steam Dollar, and two examples of stable tokens are Tether and USD Coin, as both are ERC20 tokens on Ethereum blockchain. As a key takeaway, I would recommend you to go through my video on what is tokenomics to gain more understanding on the subject. Link is there in the description below. And lastly, in order to get a rough understanding of a crypto project, you must ask the following questions before taking that leap of faith. Number 1. Is it a coin or a token? If it's a token, which blockchain is used? Does the project maybe start as a token on Ethereum and plan to transition to their own blockchain over time? This could give you an insight into which type of security tokens you might have to worry about, where the main amount of work will go into, and if the high gas prices of Ethereum and Ethereum 2.0 might be interesting for the project or not. Number 2. Choose from discussed groups. Is it a digital currency, an exchange token, a smart contract blockchain, NFT, an asset-backed token, a utility token, or something different? The answer might affect regulations and should help you understand how the project can provide value to its users. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.